When did he begin to deteriorate?
No, he didn't deteriorate. He was just always, you know, so smart. And so we didn't want to teach him reading, but he was asking the maid how to, what the words were and so on. So I thought if he wanted to learn that badly, we'd just go ahead and teach him. So, but he was kind of a problem that he wanted to, it was too much work, you know, he wanted to go ahead too quickly.
What did you think when he was young? That he might turn out to be a teacher or a president?
No, I hadn't thought what he'd be. I just knew he was a genius, and Evelyn still calls him my son the genius.
I'm glad this is being filmed.
Yeah,
there will
well,
be people who dispute it.
And she said that her son is 4 months older than Bob, and she said when they come to our house, they go home and think, what's wrong with their son? You know, because Bob was telling time when he was 2 years old, and her kid was trying to count his fingers. So she said, then they would go to another relative, the Costellos, who had a boy that was retarded. So they figured, well, her son wasn't like that. But yeah, he was, and when he went into first grade, he was just 5. And then he got sick. And we thought that he was too young to be in first grade. And the teacher said she never had anybody that could read before. And that she wanted us to leave him there and come back when he was able to, because she never had a child that could read. And Bob said they told him they were going to play a game. And he looked at the paper, and it said achievement test on it. He said it wasn't a game, it was a reading test. And that he read 4.2 when he started school. So he was our genius.
Did I ever sing much when I was young?
You didn't do any singing, no. No singing.
Well, that's quite a story.
I don't know what to ask.
Should I sing?
If you do, I'll stop it.
I mean, I can't tell time any better now than when I was 2.
No, because it's perfect.
It's 5 minutes to 6.
But I remember when you were in second grade, and you came home and you said, all the other kids have a real interesting story about a honey bear. And the teacher wanted to be very, very advanced in every way and not hold him back. So she gave him a book on the crowning of Charlemagne when he was 6 years old.
Old? I was lusting after honey bears?
No. The kids were reading, all the other kids were reading a story about the honey bears, Charlemagne, crowning of Charlemagne. And you didn't care a hoot about the crowning of Charlemagne.
Were there pictures in the book?
No. It was a history book. And so you came home and you told me about it. And then of course I told you something about Charlemagne, how he was an 800. You said you saw that in the book, but you didn't put the crown. You said, I know, he put the crown on himself instead of letting it.
He had quite an ego.